Yo, welcome back to the show. We got a very, very interesting topic that came out of nowhere, came out of left field yesterday. I happened to join the panel for a bit over at Quick Vix, and I was just kind of having fun, but also, I was serious about everything I was saying. We started talking about racism and stuff, and the use of the word nigga. All right, let's get into it.
Who's afraid of the punk police? Niggas run the streets, no justice, no peace. Fuck the law, rather draw than do time. Don't fuck with my cross the line. My two nines go buy out when I shoot them. Korean motherfuckers was quick, and some niggas had to burn and loot them. Now the streets ain't safe and not my niggas. Straight take his life, so don't sleep when my Jeep creep up. How we hit him, empty the clip, then dip, cause we did him. Licking off shots full of toss, so that's proper. Love for my niggas, but a Glock for the coppers. So what the fuck you wanna do now? I packed a 9 last year, in 99 I'm packing 2 now. And even if they pull their triggers, they can shoot one man, but nothing's gonna stop the plan of truth.
Yo, you ever seen Dead Prez is bigger than hip hop? That's the only way.
All right, listen. Hold up, guys.
And listen to the
hold
message.
Hold up. Aaron.
Yeah, everybody mute up. Mm-hmm. Everybody mute up besides Vic.
Yeah, everybody mute up except for Aaron. Aaron, do you want me to let Hand Banana up here?
For what? Who's Hand Banana? Oh, no. For what?
He might want to say something.
He has the capability of being respectful.
He might want to say something to you. If he gets disrespectful, I will kick him. Okay?
Okay.
He doesn't always read the temperature of the room well. That's all.
Yeah, he's a little different. What's up, Banana? Well,
how was all that, man? I thought we were cool. You're asking her if it's okay for me to come on panel?
Yeah.
I thought we were cool, man. Okay.
What do you mean? You thought we were cool?
Like, I don't get why I need you need her permission to be like on that panel. Like that's just
because
weird.
She's a female on my panel. That's why.
Okay, I mean, was I wasn't even saying I don't even know her, dude.
But you offended her in some type of way.
How did I offend her?
She hasn't ever
responded to me. What are you talking about?
I did respond to you.
Oh, well, I didn't hear it. Okay, maybe I just missed something then. That just seemed weird.
Can I ask you, are you black or white?
I'm black.
Okay.
You're not black.
What about you? Are you black or white?
Oh, he's not, Vic? So why are you lying and why are you in the chat saying nigga?
Listen to his voice. He sounds like a white boy in his mama's basement.
Hand Banana, that shit ain't cool.
I was asking something. Yeah, I'm Mexican. I was asking, like, so when people say nigga, it's like, oh, my nigga, it was like, what's up, my nigga, you know? It's
okay,
never like, oh, my
ER.
And
you don't even sound right saying it, though. You don't.
Oh, so I wanted to point out how annoying it is that Quick Vic and them, they never let me actually finish responding. You know, normal people would just wait until you're done talking and then ask, you know, the thing they were going to ask. You know, sometimes you don't always have to interject, and especially three people interjecting, you know, like that. It's very annoying. You guys shouldn't do that. You guys need some training on panel.
Don't even sound right.
I'm not trying to use the word right now. Can you get what?
That's all. Don't use the word right now. That's all.
Period.
I know that. I'm just saying.
But you're saying
it's not racist.
You're
I'm saying it's not face. Racist. I'm saying she's being overly sensitive. That word's not racist. You're stupid.
It is racist.
No, it's not. You're stupid.
It is racist.
No, it's not. So
I'm
you
what?
Go. So
I'm what? No, wait. Time out. I'm what?
You say it's.
All right. You know what? I'm gonna just say
he's
this.
He's out of here. Now nah, he's out of
bye
here.
Bye bye. Pow, pow, pow.
You ain't calling Aaron. What did you call her?
Fucking Vic, man. I swear. This is some bullshit. Fucking Angel's over there saying, oh, I'm gonna stick my dick in this guy's wife's ass. He's disrespecting a woman. I can't say she's stupid. Are you fucking kidding me? What the fuck? But that's what I was saying. What kind of rules are these? And also, I was right. I still think I'm right. You guys tell me how you feel in the comment section, obviously. If we're right, subscribe, like. I don't feel like it's a racist word, obviously. I think it was a word that black people took to kind of empower themselves away from the ER version of it. And then it was like, but if you're going to make a word and only black people can say it, then that's racism on its own again. So you can't have a word that's okay for certain people to say and not other people. So if you don't like the word, you know, and it's like agreed upon as a collective society not to say it, then it's cool. And you know, it's, you know, I don't know. I guess everybody's gonna do whatever they feel like they're gonna do in their geographical area. I mean, apparently I live in Phoenix, Arizona, and a lot of times you would just hear everybody say nigga. I mean, white, black, you know, friggin' everybody, Mexicans, everybody, or foo, or homie, or what's up, you know, just like gangsta, what up, G, what up, thug, just stupid shit, just anything. I mean, so somebody saying what up, nigga, is not a big deal. That's why I was saying she's stupid, because it's like, oh, okay, so what, are you gonna react by assault somebody or something? You could be like, oh, you racist, and you're gonna behave like that with them? It's like, that's stupid. That's why I was saying she's stupid. But, moving on.
Stupid. I think he called me stupid.
No,
yeah, he called me stupid.
He's sitting backstage.
Stupid, she's stupid. Well, you know what, Ham Banana?
And my complexion is darker than yours, Banana. My complexion is darker than yours.
Hold on, wait, time out. So, she can't justify her stupid views, so you protect her from a debate, protect her fragile mind, bro. I tried to express, was cut off and kicked off.
Gang, you gotta put your
justify it, laugh my ass off. She's stupid, she can't talk. You guys talking for her, laugh my ass off.
Where is he backstage?
I'm very
that?
Much so educated. I grew up in a family of educators, honey. I had a family member who was a superintendent. I'm not dumb, not the slightest. I have children that go to a blue magnet school,
Aaron,
that could probably do circles around your ass in a debate. Don't play with me.
I love when people fucking read those off. I love it. I love it because I don't have to take a picture of it and be like, this is what I said back there. You know, they just read it out loud. And it's so funny hearing them say it about themselves. I hope that sinks in. Like, what I said. And she read it out loud. So in her own voice, she's saying what I was saying to her. Yeah, your fragile mind couldn't take any criticism. So, knowing that, all these people on the panel start jumping in to protect you from any criticism on your views. Nobody can question anybody's views or criticize anybody's views there either, because you guys are all sensitive as fuck. It's like, how are we gonna have an open discussion on a panel when one of the panel members needs to be fucking safety, fucking bubble wrapped and everything from anything that might offend her ass?
Aaron, I booted him from. I didn't know he was typing back there. Fuck him.
Well, fuck you too, Quick Vic, you old bitch.
Don't even pay him no mind, sweetheart.
Yeah.
I booted him.
No, but that's the thing. Like,
he can't even come on my panel anymore.
Difference, you know. I me personally, I'm Hispanic. I'm Dominican. You know, Dominican, and
mm-hmm.
So, right, you're Dominican, right?
Yeah.
You were, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Well, I've tried like to like dilute it from my vocabulary as I gotten older because it's more of a respect thing.
Exactly, but I'm talking about growing up in New York City. You know what I'm saying? I don't know where you're from, but in New York City, have you used it?
My whole life.
Your whole life. That's your vocabulary, right?
Yeah, that's my vocabulary.
All right, it's not wrong with that. It's not because he was born and bred where he from. You know what I'm saying?
But as you know, as you do get old and you hear other people feelings on it, you know, you start to see that, you know, what I've learned also by YouTube is people more down south, and I've learned that they've expressed it to me like the more in depth how they still feel about it in 2023, as opposed to how we use it as endearment for our fellow brothers in the neighborhood. In up north, which I wrote on the comment, but these are things that I just got more insight on as I've been on the panels and stuff, because I never looked at it honestly, you know, as of I guess my demographics in my area didn't like let me notice or see anyone that had a problem with it, you know what I'm trying to say?
And I agree with you because you was born and raised in it, yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it's not like you're okay. This, you was in the suburbs and you moved to New York and now you talk like this. You was born, raised, bred in this, right?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
All right, so you using it, it's not a problem. It's not a problem because that's how you was raised, right?
Of course. And another thing, though, is like, you know, it seems like it goes forward. It's trying to go forward in a certain demographic, but it goes backwards in other demographics because in the urban culture, hip hop, you know, quote culture, it's used like if everyone was basically born or raised in the urban communities. You understand what I'm saying? So it's become a norm where it teaches white kids and Asian kids. In a way, like it diluted the meaning. The culture has diluted the meaning for people that, you know, went through these things in our history and in our culture. Right or wrong? Do you think, am I right or wrong in what I'm saying?
Right. You're absolutely right.
But guess what, though? Erin, mm-hmm. She's still on the panel?
I'm here.
Yes, she's still here.
Erin.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, my nigga, you good?
I'm cool.
All right, then. You understand that? You see that? You see that, right?
Yeah.
It's a difference because he was misusing what he knows.
All right. What I know about this lady is what she said on that panel. And she said she behaves different when she's with her black friends than she behaves with her white friends. She puts on a show for her white friends. So she's being fake around the people right now. And on panel, she's not keeping it real. She's not keeping it 100 at all. And she's letting you know, hey, I'm like 60% here. You guys don't want to know the real me, apparently. I don't know. I don't know what her issue is, but you should try being yourself, lady.
He was misusing the words. Because I heard Erin say, yo, Erin, you good, my nigga? Yo, I'm good, pop.
Be real. I got a question for you then, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Since you say, oh, you grew up that way. You was in that situation. You did this, you did that, you grew up that way. Right. So what if I was to grow up in that same situation, that same old style? Why would it be wrong for me to say it then?
It wouldn't be. As long as you were around your people.
Hold on. I'm going to shut this right down. It wouldn't be wrong. But guess what? You wouldn't talk how you talk. You wouldn't act how you act. And she would respect it. And she would recognize it.
No, okay, you're right. It wouldn't be wrong. But at a certain point, you know,
they both you have to realize in the same that you're not situation, but
you have to eliminate. You know, you have to try to eliminate it out of your vocabulary. I would think.
I think it's best to eliminate it. I ain't opposed to what you're saying, bro. I think we should say it, bro.
Like I said, I'm not here trying to knock anyone how they... I still use it to not. Just get off the phone. What's good, my nigga? You don't say what's popping, but this and right. that. You understand? But I understand the demographic and the ideology of... Unfortunately, it's that to be out here that you could use it, but you can't. And that's just what it is.
Hey, gangs, I'm going to just say this. My baby daddy is from the Bronx, Puerto Rican, white passing man. He could pass for a white man, but he's a Puerto Rican from the Bronx, right?
Oh, you got a Puerto Rican baby daddy, baby?
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
And then my other baby is from Barbados. So.
No, listen, right before you say that, not everybody that grew up in the hood, there was the people outside. The people inside didn't really, you know what I'm saying? Maybe they would use it less. But I guarantee you, he used it once or twice in his vocabulary.
Yo, listen, but it's where he was raised at, though.
I had to hear stories he could about use how that. He was when he first came to my city and how bad he used to use it and how motherfuckers got him off of that word by the time I met him.
All right, so check it out. Did they get him off the word by giving him the knowledge for him to make the decision to change it on his own, or did they pressure him into changing it? Where it was like, yo, if you say that around me, I'm going to smack
you. How you talk.
So that's called kind of being ghetto. Like, oh, I don't like the way you talk, so I'm going to assault you. I mean, arguably, some racist KKK member should be able to walk up to you and say the N-word and you not assault them. But is that what's going to happen? Probably not. Is it what I would do? Probably not. I would probably want to assault them too. Who knows? I've never been put in that kind of situation. But, I mean, I mean, that's that mentality. It's the same mentality where I'm just going to beat somebody into submission rather than explaining to them that they sound stupid or that their racism and the way it affects other humans, you know, stuff like that. You know, like he's saying, give them the knowledge to make better choices, hopefully. And if they want to live a sad, miserable life, you let them. But, you know, oh, I'm going to pressure you or beat you or, you know, punk you into submission. That's not the way to go. That doesn't make a change.
I think they gave him the knowledge. Now, the people I was with, they probably would have pressed him.
See, a guy like me, then, I'm going to say it on purpose now. And I might even change my mentality because now you don't give a fuck about teaching me or schooling me because you saw, I told you kind of where I grew up from, you know, and you didn't give me the benefit of the doubt. So now, you know what I'm saying? Who are you? Why are you going to try to press me?
That's my point, James.
I just feel like you're talking in circles, my G.
But, Gaines, this is the thing for
like,
me.
Like, you want to know why I feel like you're talking in circles, though? What? I'm trying to tell you, though. If you from where we from, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's how you talk. That's how you talk. It ain't no changing it. It ain't no going around it. It ain't nothing. You can try to change it to better you personally.
What I'm getting at is you don't even know me, right? Whether how I
no, what I was talking about is when you become a certain age and you have the, you know, the consideration for the next man. But if you're trying to press me, that consideration going out the window.
Exactly what I was saying. When you live in a city and people start fucking with you and, you know, like, oh, you said something and now they're fucking with you in the street. It doesn't matter what it was all of a sudden because now you're in a confrontation because somebody just walked up to you and wants to start some shit, you know? So it just doesn't change. It doesn't create a change. All it does is lead, you know, people in jail or dead in the street or somebody gets assaulted and now there's a criminal running around or that person gets caught and goes to jail. That's not an effective change. That's stupid. It's just oppressing yourselves, basically, because you set that, you know, we'll press them, we're gangsta, we press people, it's cool, you're setting up your whole culture and your family, what, to be in jail or what, because you press people, you go out there and do stupid shit, that's fine, that's you setting yourself up for failure, you're not creating any positive change, and if anything, you're just creating more violence in the world. And you live by the sword, you die by the sword, baby.
But see, Gaines, here's the thing. For me, I'm a person. I try to educate him just like I've been to trying to educate everyone else here. The reason why I think it's not a good thing to say. Like, my family is from the South. I've been looking at land from where my family is from. Like, where they from is not.
It just don't sound good, period. It don't sound good at all.
And then on top of that, you gotta
understand that it is a difference, yo.
Yeah,
it is a difference, and we have a divide.
We don't really tolerate that.
Yeah, we gotta divide, B.
Yeah,
and that's what we gotta realize, yo. Because I could go to Aaron right now, yo, Aaron. My nigga, you good? Yeah, I'm good, Bob. That's it. And she won't have nothing to say to me. Nothing to say to me. But if Dave, right, you go to Aaron and say, she will fucking spaz on you.
Right. That's what gets me. Because you know what? I grew up in you know, it's not, I'm not no big city cat or nothing like that.
No, you're not. You can't part of talk this, like it because you didn't the, live it.
Our part of the city I grew up in, it was what we would call the ghetto in our part of this so little tiny city.
You
can't
talk it. You have the vocabulary. That's it.
That's the bottom line. If
well, just because I don't sound like a New Yorker, I can't say nothing.
No, it ain't even necessarily where you're from, babe. It's, for me, it's a respect thing for...
Absolutely, that's why I
don't
say it. It's a respect thing.
Yeah,
it's Dave, you will never hear that word come out of my mouth.
But hold on, wait, time out, y'all. Megan wanted to put her two cents in something.
Can yeah, let Megan talk. I'm sorry about that, y'all. I apologize.
Yeah, go ahead, Megan.
Wow.
Good talk, Megan. Good talk. Hate to cut you off so soon, but the episode's over. Man, so I wasn't really advocating to say the word because I don't use it in my normal vocabulary. Sometimes I will say it jokingly or ironically, and it would be like to my brother or my friends or, you know, just something stupid. Sometimes I say it to my wife. Sometimes I say it to my mom. Sometimes I answer my phone and I'll be like, what's up, nigga? And it'll be my mom. And I know it's her. It says mom when she calls. And I do it and she'll just be like, what? Like, all the time, she's always just like, what? Like why do you answer your phone? Like, it's funny because I only do it to certain people. And one of them would be like, ironically, my mom. I think it's hilarious. She doesn't find it very funny, but I do. Either way, I mean, like, I don't think it's racist. It's like people say it's meant as a term of endearment. It's been diluted from what it was, which was African people taking power back over the word, the racist word, the very racist word. So they were taking some power back. And that's kind of how that came to be, I believe. I mean, we could do some more research on that if you want, but that's how I seen it start popping up. Yeah, anyway, I'll see you on the next one. It's going to be these same people. They have a whole nother conversation that I found hilarious. So we'll be back with this panel. Peace.